Now we'll understand the concept of proverbs with few more examples and with their meanings, right? So proverbs are used, they are the group of words that are used in daily language, which we use in our conversation. They enrich and enliven a language, that is, they make the language more beautiful and expressive. As I told you, some proverbs which we are going to take with their meanings are, first one is, there is no smoke without fire. There is no smoke without fire. And the meaning of it is, there is some truth behind every rumor. Right? Rumor, you know what is rumor? Something wrong has been said. Right? So rumor is what? Something false thing which has been, a cooked up story that has been told. So there is no smoke without fire. The meaning is, there is some truth behind every rumor. Right? The second proverb is, necessity is mother of all inventions. Necessity is mother of all inventions. This is a proverb. And the meaning is, people invent things out of need. When there is a need, then there are inventions. Then new things come up, new ideas come up, new thoughts come up, and new products come up. Right? So necessity is mother of all inventions. You know, now when there is a need, when there is requirement, then certain things and certain products, new products and new things are invented, are created. So people invent things out of need. Then the third proverb, once in a blue moon. Once in a blue moon. So what does it mean? Once in a blue moon, it means occasionally seen or occasionally appearing. Sometimes you are seen. Sometimes you go out of your house. Okay? So, what will your friend say? You appear once in a blue moon. Right? So, once in a blue moon means occasionally heard or seen. Then the fourth proverb is, a change is as good as rest. A change is as good as rest. The meaning is, change from the monotonous usual routine is refreshing. Suppose from a monotonous everyday routine you are going out for a vacation or holidays. So that is quite refreshing. So a change is as good as rest. What does it mean? Change from routine is refreshing. So I hope you understand. There are many other proverbs. The list is long. So you are now going to make a list of 20 proverbs and write it in your notebooks with their meanings. Right? Thank you. Now we are taking this exercise, small, they are the fill-ups, to make you understand the proverbs which you all must have heard or you are hearing it for the first time. So I told you that proverbs, they are generally used in English language and in our day-to-day conversations, which make the language more effective, meaningful, right? So this is a small exercise. We are having some few examples. Some words are given in the box, right? And they are the fill-ups. So we will try doing this right now, okay? So these words are book, spark, this is the help box, traits, master, best, coat, glitters. Now there are some of the proverbs, so we'll try doing it. You all also try doing with me only, okay? Just try guessing it if you can do it. Now first example we are taking it. Cut the dash according to cloth. Cut the dash according to cloth. So can you just guess it? What can be from the words which are given in the help box? Can you all just guess it? Cut the dash according to cloth. Will it be book? Will it be spark? Or trade? Or master? Or best? Or coat? Or glitters? Can you guess? Any guesses? Cut the dash according to your cloth. Cut the, what can be cut here? Cut the coat. Yes. For those who could guess it, it's very good. So cut the coat according to cloth. Cut the coat. Cut your coat according to the cloth. Right? So, that means how much resources you have, you should use only that. That limit should be there. Not whatever is the income, you should not expend or you should not waste more than that, more than your income. That means the proverb says here that you, whatever resources you should have, whatever limited resources you have, you should spend according to that only. You should spend accordingly, whatever is your income, right? So cut the coat according to the cloth. Now second, never judge a dash by its cover. This is a very common proverb. Never judge a dash by its cover. What will be? Book, spark, traits, master, best, coat or glitters. Can you guess out? Yes, the answer is never judge a book. Never judge a book by its cover. Book. Never judge a book by its cover. That is, the meaning says that never make false opinions. Like just by seeing a person, just meeting one time, you cannot form or frame opinions about the person or anything, right? So you need to interact, you need to analyze and then give your judgment or your opinion, right? Never judge a book by its cover. Then third, jack of all dash and dash of none. So can you guess over here which word will come? Book. Will it be spark, traits, master, best, coat or glitters? What will it be? Jack of all trades. Jack of all trades. Jack of all trades and master of none. And master of none. That means little knowledge of many things will not make you a complete master. Right? So shallow knowledge does not give you complete knowledge. So jack of all trades and masters of none. Small pieces of knowledge will not give you full complete knowledge of a subject. Right? Then next is experience is the dash teacher. Experience is the dash teacher. Which word will come here? Will it be book, spark, trades, master, best, coat or glitters? Can anyone guess? Yes, it's the word best. Experience is the best teacher. Okay? Experience is the best teacher. Next we'll take a small dash makes a fire. Which word will come here? A small dash makes a fire. Book or spark or trade or master, best, coat or glitters. Can you guess? Yes, the word will be spark. A small spark makes a fire. Do you know what spark is? Do you know what spark is? It's a small, just like matchstick. Okay, it's something which starts, ignites a fire. Spark is chingari, right? A small spark makes a fire. With a little spark, the whole fire can be lit. It can be a big fire. Okay, a small spark makes a fire. That means, if a small thing is told about somebody, that can create big fights among people. The meaning of it is this. A small spark makes a fire. A misunderstanding. A small misunderstanding can create big fights among people. Okay. Now next is all the dash is not gold. All that dash is not gold. So which word will come here? Book, spark, trades, master, best, coat or glitters. Yes, it is glitters. All that glitters is not gold. all that glitters is not gold. So there are few examples, and we have also done some fill-ups with the words completing the proverbs. So as I told you, that proverbs are those words which modify, which express the language, our day-to-day English language, and improve our expressions in writing, speeches, or speaking, right? So I hope the content of proverbs of Unit E is clear to you all. Thank you so much. Good morning, students. So we are here with Unit E, and the name of the chapter that we are going to study of your dear book are proverbs, right? So we are going to understand what are proverbs. So proverbs, you see, they are a group of words which are meaningful words, and they express deeper meanings, right? And they are used in daily conversations. Like, they are the words, group of words which are having some meaning. They are words, advice words, they are words of wisdom, and they are used in day-to-day life. It makes the language of English more expressive and more meaningful, right? So why are proverbs, when are they used, and why are the proverbs used? They are used to beautify, to quantify, and to modify the language of English, right? So we are going to understand with few examples. The first that we are taking, the first proverb that we are taking as an example is, the cat is out of the bag. So this is a proverb. The cat is out of the bag. Okay, so let's understand the meaning. That secret has been revealed. This is the meaning of the proverb, the cat is out of the bag, right? Likewise, we are taking second example. The forbidden fruit is sweetest. The forbidden fruit is sweetest. So the meaning of it is, what you are not allowed to do is more tempting. Like, if you are told that not to do this thing, then out of curiosity you would like to do it. So in these two examples, we are seeing that they are group of words. Like, the cat is out of the bag, they are group of words which have got a meaning. They are meaningful words, right? And the meaning of it is that which has to be not leaked out. That's secret. Secret means the thing which you do not have to tell everybody. So secret has been revealed. The meaning of it is secret has been revealed, right? Now in the second example, the forbidden fruit is sweetest. Forbidden means that which you are not allowed to do. Like, don't do this. Don't do this work. Suppose your mother says, do not go to that place, or do not touch this thing. Then you would like to do it. You would like to touch it, or you would like to go to that place and find out. So you would have more curiosity to do it. So the forbidden fruit is sweetest. That is, the meaning of it is, what you are not allowed to do, you want to do it out of curiosity. It is more tempting, that you would like to do it. Now, so you can understand that by using these, like the cat is out of the bag, or the forbidden fruit is sweetest, like suppose you are using in sentence, so it beautifies the language, okay, and it tells some meaning, it expresses some meaningful action. So proverbs, we would understand by these two examples that they are words which express deeper meanings, right? They make the language more expressive, interesting, and they are used in daily life conversations, right? They are used in speeches, they are used in writings, so they make the language more effective, right? So we will understand proverbs with a few examples.